From delusion to wisdom, awakening from the dream. Delusion has the characteristic of blindness, of not penetrating reality, of covering the true nature of experience, of fostering unwise attention, of causing deluded action. Visuddhimagga. Hey there. You've been asleep for a long time. Isn't it time to awaken? Sign on the entry path to Ajahn Chah's monastery. The goal of Buddhist psychology is to help us see clearly. When we are lost in delusion, it's hard to see even the most obvious truths. Ajahn Chah said, "It's like we're riding a horse and asking, 'Where's the horse?'" One of the most stunning revelations of modern psychology is how very wrong our habitual perception can be. In a study done at Harvard University, Daniel Simon showed a 3-minute basketball video and asked the observers to count how many times a basketball was passed between the black team and the white team. After a minute, a person in a gorilla suit walks slowly to the very middle of the court, faces the camera, beats his chest, and then walks away. At the end of 3 minutes, 50% of those watching the video missed the gorilla altogether. They were so busy counting, the basketball was all they saw. Even when asked if anything unusual had happened, they firmly said no. When the video was played back to them, their mouths dropped open in amazement. The gorilla is so obvious, yet they never saw a thing. Of course, sometimes it is helpful to ignore distractions, even a video gorilla, so that we can focus on certain tasks to the exclusion of others. In fact, meditation can help us with that. But we also need to realize how one-sided our view of things can be, how much of reality we may be missing. Often we see only what we want to believe. We can be famously deluded about love, and equally so about our bodies, our plans, our finances, our past, and our future. Whole nations can be deluded about their domestic or foreign policy. "You live in illusion and the appearance of things," says Tibetan Lama Kala Rinpoche. "There is a reality, but you do not know this." Without seeing clearly, we take the surface illusion of things to be reality. Delusion underlies all the other unhealthy states. Grasping and clinging arise from the delusion of scarcity, an inability to sense our wholeness and life's abundance. Aversion and hatred arise from a misguided search for security, from the mistaken belief that hatred can make us safer. And at the root of delusion itself is the illusion of a separate, limited sense of self. Freedom from delusion is so important that the first words of the Buddha after his enlightenment were a poem describing this liberation. "O house builder, thou art seen at last," he proclaims. "The ridge pole is broken, the rafters are shattered. No more shall you build this house of sorrow." Delusion is the ridge pole that holds up the rafters of clinging, anger, fear, and sorrow. Seeing through delusion, the Buddha liberated himself from the house of human suffering and walked away free. When we awaken from delusion, our life is transformed. This is not easy, because the ridgepole of delusion is hard to see. When conflict and dissension arose among the monks at Ajahn Chah's monastery, he would stop them and say, "See this clearly. This is ignorance. This is delusion." Delusion has a seductive power, and it can appear anywhere. Buddhist texts tell of the famous quarrel at Kosambi when the Buddha's own monks wouldn't listen to him in their conflict. Zen Master Dogen warns us how quickly delusion can appear. "One enlightened thought and you are a Buddha. One ordinary thought and you're again a deluded person." As a meditation teacher, I've seen delusion even at the top of the Buddhist world. There are certain masters and their disciples who arrogantly denigrate the practices of other masters or abuse their students, believing that it is for the student's own good. When I'm honest, I see that I too can be arrogant and insensitive. I too can get caught by my own delusions. Delusion is different from lack of information. It is different from not knowing how a gasoline engine works or the facts of Middle Eastern history. Delusion can lead us to ignore the facts and cling to our views and opinions. It creates a loss of connection with reality. At its extreme, delusion becomes outright psychosis. Our ordinary delusion can take us from the reality of the present into the unreality of our thoughts and confused misperceptions. With delusion, we can get lost in a dreamy and unconscious life. Even reading this chapter about delusion can put you to sleep. Notice how it works. Through awareness, we can release the spell of delusion and the suffering it creates. This is a 15th principle of Buddhist psychology. Delusion misunderstands the world and forgets who we are. Delusion gives rise to all unhealthy states. Free yourself from delusion and see with wisdom.